नमस्कार दोस्तों, आपका अपने चैनल मनोज गुप्ता एकेडमी में आपका स्वागत है। दोस्तों आज हम क्लास सेवेंथ के हिस्ट्री एंड सिविक्स में सिविक्स लेसन नंबर 1 इंट्रोडक्शन टू अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इस लेसन का एक्सरसाइज करने वाले हैं। सो फ्रेंड्स, अभी तक आप लोगों ने इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल, लाइक कीजिए और अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ शेयर कीजिए। दोस्तों आप लोग इस वीडियो को अच्छी तरीके से देख करके अच्छी तरीके से सुन करके भी इसके क्वेश्चन आंसर राइट कर सकते हैं। यह है लेसन नंबर 1 इंट्रोडक्शन टू अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, उसका एक्सरसाइज कर लेते हैं। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन में क्या दिया गया, एक्सप्लेन द फॉलोइंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स। फर्स्ट, प्रोविजंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। द आंसर इज प्रोविजंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मीन्स स्पेलिंग आउट डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द गवर्नेंस ऑफ अ स्टेट और कंट्री। दिस इंक्लूड्स फर्स्ट provisions regarding the citizenship and the rights of the citizen. Second, provisions related to powers of the government and the restrictions thereon. Third, provisions relating to the relationship between the citizens and the government. And fourth, provisions related to elections. Now next, second, Constitution Day. The answer is every year 26th November is observed as the Constitution Day in India. This is due to the fact that the Constitution Assembly had enacted and adopted the Constitution of India on 26th November 1949. Now next question karte hain. Question number 2, discuss. First, a Constituent Assembly was established. The answer is first, the leaders of the freedom movement insisted that independent India will not be governed by the laws made by the British government. Second, that insisted that independent India will be governed by the laws made by the people of India. Therefore, to prepare a constitution of independence India, the Constitution Assembly was established. Now next, second, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar is called the architect of the Indian Constitution. The answer is first, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar was the chairman of the drafting committee. Second, he had studied the constitution of the many countries in depth and drafted our constitution. Third, he had presented the draft constitution before the Constituent Assembly. Fourth, he was discussed article by article and amendments were suggested. Fifth, he answered the issues raised and made the required changes in the draft. Sixth, he made every provision of the constitution flawless. Due to his contribution in making of our constitution, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar is called the architect of the Indian Constitution. Now next, third, what is included in the administration of a country? The answer is first, governance or administration is the process of taking decision regarding the issues before the country. Governance is undertaken by the government. Second, the government has to make laws relating to defending boundaries, protection from external aggression, eradication of poverty, creating employment, education, health, commerce, industries, protecting of weaker section, progress of women, children and tribal people, etc. Now next question. Third, choose the right option. First, the constitution of this country is primarily unwritten. Option is America, India, England, none of the above. The answer is England. Now next. Second, who was the president of the Constituent Assembly? Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Durga Bhai Deshmukh, B.N. Rao. The answer is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Now next. Third, who among these was not a member of the Constituent Assembly? Mahatma Gandhi, Maulana Azad, Rajkumari Amrit Kaur, Hansa Ben Mehta. The answer is Mahatma Gandhi. Now next. Fourth, who was the chairman of the drafting committee? Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, J.B. Kriplani. The answer is Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. Now next question. Question number 4, answer the following questions. First, on what subject does the government have to make laws? The answer is, the government makes laws on the following subjects. First, the defense of the country and protecting people from external aggression. Second, eradication of poverty and creating employment. Third, education and health services, framing policies to protect the weaker sections and progress of women, children, the tribal people. Fifth, encouragement to commerce and industries. Now next, second, why do we celebrate 26th January as Republic Day? The answer is, we celebrate 26th January as the Republic Day बिकॉज फर्स्ट द इंडियन रिपब्लिक केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस ऑन दैट डे, सेकंड द कंट्री बिगेन टू बी गवर्न्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम 26 जनवरी 1950. नाउ नेक्स्ट थर्ड, व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ रनिंग अ कंट्री एज पर द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. द आंसर इज ऑलमोस्ट ऑल कंट्रीज इन द वर्ल्ड हैव एक्सेप्टेड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ गवर्नेंस अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ड्यू टू द फॉलोइंग एडवांटेजेस. फर्स्ट, the government has to function within the rules set by the constitution. This reduces the possibility of misuse of power and high-handed administration. Second, the rights and freedom of the people are included in the constitution. The government cannot take away these rights. Thus, the constitution protects the rights and freedom of the people. Third, it establishes the rule of law. Fourth, the faith of the common people and their participation in the government increases. This strengthens democracy. Fifth, the constitution sets political ideas such as world peace, security and preservation of human rights. The government is bound to act in that direction. Sixth, the constitution states the duties of the citizens and fixes their responsibilities. So friends, आज हमारा यहाँ पे lesson number 1 का exercise complete हुआ. Friends, आप लोगों को ये video कैसा लगा आप लोग comment box पे जरूर लिख करके बताइए. इस video को ज्यादा से ज्यादा like कीजिए, अपने friends के साथ share कीजिए ताकि उनको भी question answer मिल सके, और इस channel को subscribe कीजिए. नमस्कार दोस्तों.